The role of a neuron is to receive and transmit information. Neurons receive information with the dendrite. The dendrite receives information either from a junction with another neuron called a synapse, or the dendrite may be differentiated as a sense receptor to detect specific sensory stimuli, such as chemicals for taste and smell, pressure or heat for hearing and touch, or wavelengths of light for vision. If the dendrite is a sensory receptor, it responds to the intensity of the sensory stimulus. In the case of taste and smell, it is the amount of the chemical. For hearing or touch, it is the loudness of the sound, or the heat or pressure on the skin. And for vision, it is the brightness of the light. The intensity of the stimulus produces a proportional electrical depolarization or reversal of charge in the dendrite. This graded depolarization is called the receptor potential. If the stimulus intensity is too weak, the receptor potential dies out before it reaches the axon cone, and the neuron does not convey any information about the stimulus. However, if the stimulus intensity is sufficiently strong to cause a receptor potential that reaches the axon cone, it will generate action potentials in the axon. Action potentials are all-or-none responses, so they are not proportional to the intensity of the stimulus. The more intense the stimulus, the greater the receptor potential in the dendrite, and the higher the frequency of the action potentials in the axon. A low-intensity stimulus causes a weak receptor potential and a low frequency of action potentials. A moderate-intensity stimulus causes a stronger receptor potential and a higher frequency of action potentials. And finally, a strong stimulus produces a large receptor potential and a high frequency of action potentials in the axon. In the previous scene, we described the covering of the axon by the Schwann cells. Here we shall explain what that means functionally. Schwann cells enclose the axon surface of vertebrate neurons in a tight myelin sheath. The myelin sheath of vertebrate neurons is not continuous and is interrupted at intervals with gaps called the nodes of Ranvier. Action potentials are not conducted along the axonal membrane that is covered by the myelin sheath. Rather, action potentials progress along the axon by saltation or jumping between the nodes of Ranvier. The action potential at one node induces an electrical depolarization in the exposed excitable axon membrane of the next node, which causes the action potential to appear at that node and so on down the axon. By contrast, the loose continuous tunication of invertebrate axons by Schwann cells does not block the action potential, and the action potential progresses along the entire membrane surface of the axon. Myelination means that action potentials travel along axons more rapidly in vertebrate neurons as compared to tunicated invertebrate neurons. We will now examine how information is conveyed through the nervous system. Our model for information transfer will be a grasshopper hair receptor to a synapse in a ganglion of the ventral nerve cord, since the insect model is a simpler nervous system than that of vertebrates. Also, for simplicity, we shall omit Schwann cell tunication of the axons in order to more easily visualize the action potentials.